The Forbidden Forest is one of the darkest, creepiest places in Harry Potter. It's home to many different magical creatures, including mysterious centaurs and unicorns, and dangerous werewolves and bugbears. But have you ever wondered why this haunting place is located right next to, well, a school with children in it? Today, I explain the true reason the Forbidden Forest exists. Hey everyone! The Forbidden Forest is one of those things that everyone sort of takes for granted or just doesn't think about enough. Because with scenes in 6 of the 7 books, readers of Harry Potter get to know the forest as simply part of the Hogwarts grounds, not stopping to think about how strange its location actually is. But first, some limited background and history, as we really don't know too much about how the forest came to be in the first place. Acromantulas, centaurs, unicorns, thestrals, werewolves, giants, bugbears, bowtruckles, and trolls are all magical animals that have lived in the forest at some point. The most dangerous of these are probably giants, but only a few of them were rumored to be living there besides Gromp. And of course, Aragog and his spider colony were quite menacing, but they only came after Hagrid was in Hogwarts in the early 1940s, meaning that, for all it's hyped up to be, the forest is actually not as dangerous as most people believe. This explains a lot, because even though the forest is so-called forbidden, we see an astonishing number of students and faculty enter it throughout the series. As I said earlier, Harry enters it in 6 of the 7 books, and 3 of those 6 were ordered or encouraged by a professor. I mean, who holds detention in a treacherous place that's typically forbidden to students? For people like Fred and George, detention would be rewarding, as they get to enter a restricted area. It's so odd, Hogwarts preaches not going into the forest, and yet we see several examples of students entering the forest as if there was no risk whatsoever. But before even this, we have to go back and ask ourselves why the Forbidden Forest exists in the first place, and why it's right next to Hogwarts. We know that the forest is very old, but we don't know how old, and so we have no idea if it was there before Hogwarts was established in the 10th century. It supposedly started as a small centaur would, as the centaurs themselves say that the forest belongs to them, but this again is just a rumor. But to go straight to the main question, why on earth would a school be built next to a forest as allegedly dangerous as this one? It makes no sense. Why put children in danger when there are plenty of other concealed locations? Endangered species like centaurs and unicorns need places to go, but it doesn't have to be a stone throws away from the Quidditch pitch. These two ideas combined lead me to believe that the Forbidden Forest is actually hiding more secrets than it seems. For one, it makes much more sense that the forest would be established sometime after Hogwarts was founded for some unknown purpose. But what really makes sense is that the forest was set up to scare children away because there is, or there was, something hidden in it. As I mentioned earlier, the creatures aren't incredibly dangerous, and we see students enter the forest several times, and yet the Hogwarts staff makes a specific point to call it forbidden. Sounds like a recipe for using decoy scariness to turn kids away, while something hidden and secret lies in the middle of it. This is even alluded to in Hogwarts Mystery with the Cursed Vaults, 5 legendary hidden rooms around Hogwarts, one of which was inside the Forbidden Forest. The forest was created to either hide something, or to keep students and even certain teachers from discovering something, and that's the true reason it's labeled as forbidden. This may not be something current headmasters are even aware of, as the secret might not have been passed down. But I'd really like to hear your ideas of what could be hidden away in the forest down in the comment section. I might make a follow-up video to this if I get new info, so comment what you think or any Hogwarts history knowledge you have. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe so you don't miss any future Harry Potter content. Thanks so much for watching. See you later.